Yeah. Lil Brunson back at you with the back at you, and I am the best reporting on the Eagles. So we bring in Javon Hargrave, and that move is just, you know, brilliant. It's brilliant. You got to think about it like this. Now, a lot of the cornerbacks wanted a lot of money. They got snatched off the market. I didn't believe Byron Jones, and I agree with 500. This move is better than bringing in Byron Jones. You talking about bringing in somebody who is identically as disruptive as Fletcher Cox. Period. And you still gonna have Malik Jackson. So this don't mean Malik Jackson out the door. Somebody said, well, I hope this means Malik Jackson is out the door. Malik Jackson played one game. You don't know if that experiment was going to work out or not. So I hope this doesn't mean Malik Jackson is out the door. But at the same time, this move is pure brilliance. Pure brilliance. In the sense that if you can't get one of these cornerbacks that was on the market and supposed to be good, like James Bradbury, Byron Jones, what else could you do? You can make sure that you're in a position to be able to get some pressure to the quarterback. And I think that's the Philadelphia Eagles' main objective with a move like this, is how can we get pressure to the quarterback? And it's just brilliant, man. I mean, this dude is a stud. We made him the highest paid nose tackle in the league, and we did it for a reason. We didn't do it because we don't think that he could play. I mean, we didn't do it because, you know, we were just anxious to have somebody of that caliber. It was done because this dude fits the description, and nobody's going to be able to play alongside Fletcher Cox. And you know, for the past few years, nobody has been able to play alongside Fletcher Cox and capitalize off Fletcher Cox being double-teamed. Tim Jernigan wasn't able to be as disruptive as we thought he would be, and we don't know what happened with Malik Jackson. But this guy is going to be disruptive from the get. Disruptive. I'm talking about if Fletcher Cox was to be out for an extended period of time, God forbid, you ain't missing nothing in a disruptive department. You ain't missing nothing. And it's a brilliant move by the Philadelphia Eagles, man. We also bring back Nate Sudfeld on a one-year deal. That was a no-brainer to me. I think Bleacher Report or whoever it was, they said that, you know, this is a C move, bringing in Javon Hargrave. A C move. How is it a C move? They're saying that if we don't capitalize on some of the free agent wide receivers, then this move was a C move. These dudes don't really know football. There was only one good free agent wide receiver out there. One good one out there. And you're talking about a guy that was bound to go back to Dallas anyway. You know what I mean? I'm drawing the blank, man. What's the guy's name, man? Amari Cooper. You know what I mean? That was the only good free agent wide receiver out there. So if we made a bad move by not getting a guy who stayed with his team, that don't even make sense to me. You know what I mean? But these guys swear they know what they're talking about, man. They don't know what they're talking about. They don't know the amount of space that has been freed up by Stephon Diggs going to Buffalo. Buffalo was surely to be able to take a wide receiver. The Cardinals were surely to be able to take a wide receiver in this upcoming draft. And these guys pick ahead of us. So why would we jump for these guys who want... Look at Stephon Diggs. Look what was given up for Stephon Diggs. A king's ransom. A first-round pick and multiple picks to follow. A king's ransom. I'm glad we didn't make a move like that. I'm glad. Now, In terms of DeAndre Hopkins, maybe the opportunity wasn't afforded to us because we would have gave him more than a fourth round pick. But you're talking about Stephon Diggs, who's already under a contract. And you're talking about DeAndre Hopkins, who, if he ain't under contract, getting paid a lot anyway, as opposed to getting a Judy, a Lamb, or a Henry Ruggs that will have to play under their rookie tenure for the next 4 years, making sure that you have cap space for the times moving forward. Now, all these teams making moves like the Giants, the Redskins really didn't make the moves. The Giants are really being active as of now. They got to. The Giants are the bottom of the barrel. The Giants are buns. They got to be active. We're not worrying about what the Giants doing and bringing in Blake Martinez and bringing in James Bradbury. We're not worrying about that. None of those were blockbuster moves. They can go ahead and fraud to y'all if they want. We've seen this story play out before. The Dallas Cowboys go get Randall Cobb. They go get that other pass rusher, Robert Quinn. They do all this stuff and don't even make the playoffs. The Philadelphia Eagles are going to win a division no matter what none of these guys do, because at the bottom line, we got Carson Wentz, and there's still a lot of free agents out there left. Today is the day, I believe, that this week sometime, I believe Howie Roseman gets something done, and we put the league on notice. We put the league on notice with a blockbuster move. I just can't wait to see which one it is.